the story of Isabel Grandmaison, which when it was first heard in the later part of the 18th century, all of France was sort of wowed by this story. And it's the story of an elite woman from Peru trying to rejoin her husband, Jean Godon, who was in French Guiana. And she's got to go from the Andes in Riobamba down the Rio Bobanaza to the Amazon and then rejoin her husband, which at that time no woman had ever done. And what happens is she leaves Riobamba carried in a sedan chair, and within a very short order, the expedition falls apart. Eventually, she is wandering alone in the jungle at the lower part of the Bobanaza. She has given up for lost. Her brothers die. And then, quite remarkably, she gets up when everybody else is dead, wanders for 8 more days in the jungle, eventually gets back to the river, is rescued by indigenous people, and rejoins her husband, who she had not seen for 20 years. So it's an amazing story of survival in a wilderness that is very, very difficult. Oh, well, at the time, there was two types, really. On one hand, there were on the upper part of the Bobanaza, in that part, there were really some wild Indians there. By wild, I mean they were hostile to anybody coming through the territory, and there was worry that they would kill anybody who came down this river, and in fact, two of the members of the party were eventually slaughtered by indigenous people at that part. But if you got down lower on the river, there had been some mission stations, and those people were more used to some travelers from the Jesuits if you got to the Amazon. So they had to pass this wilderness. So the irony of this story is the indigenous people were quite feared going past them, but it was two indigenous people that eventually saved Isabel.
Yeah.
So long ago, I had lived in Ecuador for a time, way back in 1976, fell in love with the country, and hadn't been back for a long time. And so really, I wanted to go back to South America and experience the country. And I began reading about different histories. And I came upon this history of Isabel's trip down the Amazon, but it had never been documented. It was sort of a myth. And you'd see little tales about it, like in a story of the history of the Amazon, about this woman who wandered lost, but no one had ever really documented where would she get lost, who she was, the time. And so it was a mystery that seemed worthy of documentation. So really, that was it. It was sort of floating out there in mythology, the mythology of the Amazon. A woman had gone down, got lost, but no one had really seen where it was, really how long she wandered, who she was, and how extraordinarily difficult it was.